It's every football fan's favorite time of the season once again. The January transfer window has opened, and I want to talk about a couple of Ghanaian players I feel really, really need a transfer. First player I want to talk about is Mubarak Wakaso, currently on loan at Las Palmas from Rubin Kazan. Now, Wakaso has not had the best of luck when it comes to transfers, from the time that he left Rubin Kazan through to Celtic, now back in Spain with Las Palmas. 9 league appearances for Mubarak Wakaso, in which he started just 4. And in the last game, he was allowed onto the pitch for just 30 seconds. I feel Wakaso is too talented of a player to be wasting his time on the bench. I think that this January transfer window, he needs to sort out his career and find a destination where his talents will truly be appreciated. He's tenacious, he's got a powerful left foot, but his propensity for fouling and yellow cards is something that coaches seem to be unwilling to take a risk on. It means Wakaso needs to look at himself carefully and perhaps change his style. But Wakaso, this January, I suggest you find a move that truly fits your style. Second player I want to talk about on my list, Jonathan Mensah. Now, we all know the history with Jonathan Mensah and Evianto Nogaya after the ruling from Udinese led to a 6-month ban. In the period since, he's played once. Now, the problem with Jonathan Mensah is this. He has a very, very touchy injury record, and it looks like a lot of teams are unwilling to take a risk on him. We all heard the rumors of Celtic looking for him and whatnot. That did not materialize. But I think that when fit, Jonathan Mensah is as good a central defender as you can get around, as he has shown in recent times for the national team of Ghana. I think that Evianto Nogaya in the French Ligue 2 is not the place for the talents of Jonathan Mensah. He could find a move to a club like Cayenne, Bordeaux, Angers. These are places that if he's fit, I think that he could make a reasonable impression. So Jonathan Mensah needs to find a move out. Now, this name should not be a surprise for you guys out there who like to follow me and know how I feel about Kwadwo Asamoah. Probably my favorite player in the entire world. But I think that Kwadwo Asamoah needs to leave Juventus. Now, we like to associate Kwadwo Asamoah with Juventus, but injuries have blighted his progress. The fact that he plays in a position where he is not a regular seems to have blighted his progress. Kwadwo Asamoah will never, ever be a world-class left-back or a left-wing-back. He'll be a competent wing-back, but we know that Kwadwo Asamoah has the potential to be a world-class central midfielder. He has proven it at the highest levels at a World Cup. I think Kwadwo Asamoah needs to leave Juventus in order to fulfill his true potential as a central midfielder, in order to take his place as perhaps the most talented Ghanaian player we have seen in the past decade. Kwadwo Asamoah, this January, needs to make that very, very big decision and tell himself that, look, Juventus, I have run my race with you. I do not seem to be winning the fitness battle. I do not seem to be winning the tactical battle. I have become an also-run in a team that at the moment seems to rely on also-runs. Juventus, Kwadwo Asamoah must part ways. Now, Christian Atu is another name on my list, and that should not surprise you guys out there. He's become a serial loanee, perhaps Ghana's most prolific loan player in the past year. Since his move to Chelsea, he's been at Vitesse Arnhem, he's done Everton where he did not cut it, and he's been at Bournemouth where, again, injuries and poor form seem to have blighted his progress. And now he has been recalled by Chelsea, and what we have been told is that it looks like they'll find another loan to see whether it will help. I think that this is a good decision. They should send him out of England though, because I don't think that Christian Atu's style will cut it. Atu showed at the AFCON that when he's in form, he's as good a player on the continent as there is. That is why he was voted the best player at the AFCON. But I think that he will only be able to materialize as a world-class talent in Germany, Holland, or perhaps Spain. When he was at Vitesse Arnhem, he was voted player of the season by his club. And he's shown time and time again that he has the capacity to survive. But the player again must convince himself that, look, I'm happy to be a Chelsea player. Ghanaians love to associate their players with Chelsea, but that is not what matters. I need playing time. I need to make an impression. And particularly in 2016, when World Cup qualifiers will start, Atu needs to start making a bigger case for himself. So I suggest that Christian Atu finds a deal out of England to get more playing time this season. Final player on the list of transfers that I want to look at this season is Bernard Mensah. Now, he had an astonishing 2015 season with Vitoria Guimaraes, scored 9 goals, 5 assists, caught the eye of Atletico Madrid, who spent a whopping £10 million to bring him to Spain. Now, they've loaned him to Getafe, and things have not gone out too well. He's yet to start a game, and the most minutes he's played is what? A full game in the Copa del Rey? I don't think that is what the talent of Bernard Mensah deserves. I think that the offensive midfielder is just starting his career. He's 21 years old. I think that he needs to find a club, just like one of the players that I mentioned, Burak Wakasu, that will appreciate his skill set. He's a strong runner with the ball, good dribbling skills, and has a fantastic shooting right foot. I think that another La Liga club, perhaps Celta Vigo or Malaga, will be more attuned to the skill set of Bernard Mensah, where he can truly, truly develop his potential and become perhaps the true star or future star of Ghanaian football.